Here is another Subaru with Scott Speed. He won the bracket battles in Utah. Can he do it again? Steve Arpin, I truly believe this is going to be one heck of a battle. I think they're going to stay off each other, not going to be as physical as some of the other battles we've seen so far. But I still think their racecraft is going to be really interesting to watch.
I think Arpin's got a great car underneath him, hasn't he? He just feels really comfortable in there. And Speed, too.
All right, here we go. Getting the whole shot is Scott Speed. Gets that inside line, and there goes Arpin. Like I said, he just almost got the back bumper, but now he backed off. So the 41 of Scott Speed and that Subaru gets the jump. Steve Arpin over the hip. Let's see how they handle this hairpin.
Arpin's almost out, dragged him down to the hairpin. He gets a little bit too deep. Oh, he's hoping for the inside line. The exit tag speed just a little bit there, but it's close enough. But look at Arpin's car underneath him. He looks so fast down through here. He will joker, and he's going to try and do this on lap time.
Look at this. So he takes a lower line. Again, there's a bump when you go into the low line and when you exit the low line.
I'm still loving the fact that they're able to lean on that dirt bank on the exit there. That's really working for me in terms of being able to get on the gas early, hook that car up and get an exit. Speed's got him by a few kart lengths here, but I'm sure Arpin's going to go for the tactics.
All right, you said that he'd take the joker lap, and yes, he does. So Steve Arpin goes in, and again, another real good exit. He got into that kind of curtain there on the side. But let's see how he handles this.
3.2 is the gap. Keep your eye on that gap. That's what's going to tell us whether or not Arpin is feeling as comfortable in that car run by Loughborough and GRX together as he was in the previous round. He looked unstoppable, but if anyone can stop him, Scott Speed. He won the battles last time out. He takes a tenth off Arpin this time.
I think he lost a little bit of time there. Kind of got held up on the hairpin. Scott Speed absolutely whipping through that section. I believe he's going to take the high line. Yes, he does.
The Hyundai just looks so drivable, Jared. He really does look like he's able to send it and hold it whatever angle he wants to. The gap's staying pretty similar. They'll go up the hill. We'll get another good idea here if Scott's going to hold on to the final lap or not.
Those Subarus are not the quickest through that. Oh, there we go. So Scott Speed goes to that Yokohama Joker lap. And Steve Arpin obviously does gain some ground, but not enough.
Interesting that Speed responded this time. You know, they've gone the full distance before, but they obviously feel that Arpin is quick enough. Oh, Arpin is out, lands on the front right corner, it falls, the car fails, and he's parked on the track. The whole front right corner is off. Arpin just landed that at such an extreme angle, Jared. He's unlucky, I think, there, but also maybe lucky not to go end over end.
Woo. Wow, that front right corner took the brunt of it. Scott Speed is going to continue on. And now the work begins for tomorrow. That's the reality of it now, as Scott Speed looks like he's crawling through the rest of the course. I think he just got word from his spotter, hey, take it easy. Arpin's out. You're going to win. Not the way you want to win, of course, but nah. Steve Arpin, dude, I mean, he's okay. Driver's out of the car. And he is okay. Man, that was crazy.
Yeah, limited re-prep time for Subaru. You know, they know they've got one battle to come. They know it's against a class acting Kevin Hansen. So Speed's going to get that car back. They'll get it prepped as quick as they can, ready for the final battle where we get to see who is top qualifier tomorrow. Those guys, I think, will end up on pole in the two. But look at this. I mean, he's stood it on its nose as it came over the crest. I think it's the jump on the exit of turn one. We saw Tanner get big air, didn't we, on that inside line, almost as if there's just a slight lip, maybe a bit of a kicker. There's the strut in the middle of the road. We're getting good at this, aren't we?
Yeah, wow. Just, shocking. It is.
That looks all right, though. Yeah. Well, maybe
throw,
not.
Throw her back in there.
Yeah.
Shout out to our safety team, hardworking team. They join us at every round of Nitro Rallycross. So he's going to rub some hemp fusion on that vehicle and bring it back to life. You know, alternative medicine. All right, so Speed, there's Arpin. There he is. The Canadian Cowboy, sometimes that bucks back, man. Whoops.
Sorry about that.
Yeah. Look at this.
He's going to go back. Is he going back to pick up some of the parts himself? I think he is.
Wow, look at that.
Isn't that the rim? That's the rim with the hub attached to the back of it.
Yep.
Rim's broken. That's lower arm part.
You know,
right?
Not the technicians and mechanics, they're not real hyped on that. But, yeah.
I think we're going to see that back. So let's take a look at Arpin's jump. He's going to come up screen left. There he is.
Bye.
Ooh.
Wow. Well, yeah, look at the fluid running out of the reservoir.
It fired the shock absorber straight out the front corner, didn't it? The rim's dug in and it's pulled the corner off the car. Oh, we're going to see it from the drone as well. So let's see if he takes that right-hand line that we saw Tanner take, Jared. Because remember the launch that Tanner got on the inside here?
Yep. See how it bucked?
Yeah.
So on that right side, there's like a pre-jump before the roller. It's like a booter. What's up? All right, so crazy for Steve Arpin, but Scott Speed will be getting the victory. As our finals are set, Kevin Hansen and Scott Speed.
We've dragged another guest in. Well, he kind of just turned up here in the tower, but that's fine.
I don't think he's one of our favorites. I mean, he just forced his way Ooh, in here.
That's hard.
It's not ideal, is it, mate? That was not. So what are you saying? The inside line on that jump after turn one. Fraser McConnell's here, guys, as you haven't seen him just yet. Watch this look. It's such a kicker. We saw Tanner get super high there as well.
Wow, he's really overshot it. That can't feel nice.
But is it different on the right-hand side, Franz? Because to us, you see there's like a ridge. Of the car. Have you noticed that in the car or not really?
I mean, not that drastic. I haven't jumped it that far, but, you know, it could be many things. Maybe the slide hadn't finished, you know, having all that momentum going sideways and flick back the next way. But, well, that's super unfortunate. Very probably surprising for him.
He's still smiling. It's like if you did it, you're like, oh, well, it's okay. Like, I mean, it looks like a hidden little booter there.
So surprising is kind of an understatement, isn't it? I think it was quite surprising for him when the the $40,000 corner came off the car.
I'd be surprised when the invoice starts going up.
That's going to be the surprise, isn't it?
Well, we're getting Steve Arpin towed off here. So we'll get to talk to Fraser. But Katie Osborne is with the Canadian Cowboy, Mr. Steve Arpin.
Yeah, you know, he told me at the very beginning of this he was going to send it, and that was exactly what you did. First, are you okay?
I'm fine. These guys built me such a good car, and these Yokohama tires just built so much grip that I think I was going to have a good run there. It's the famous racing line, right? But if I would have made it, we would have had them. But honestly, the car is great. Scott's just so good. He's so smooth. He's so fast. I just don't have that rhythm yet. And I just got to thank all these guys. Feel bad that we tore up this race car, but we're going to put Hemp Fusion on the podium tomorrow for sure.
And we got to thank you for taking us trackside. This is quite the view over here, but really, what happened behind the wheel?
I think I might have got into, there's a little wet spot on the very bottom going around turn one. And I just got, as I was going up the jump, it got about fishtaily on me. And when it took off, he calls me the Canadian Cowboy, the Bull One this time.
So that's one way to put it. Steve, we're glad to see you that you're okay and that you have a good car that can run pretty quick here.
Hey, we just got to say one more thing. Hemp Fusion takes a risk on a guy like me, a no-name guy like me. So anyone who wants good CBD products, hempfusion.com. Check out discount code ARPIN at discount, 25% off and free shipping, one time only. So make sure to support those guys that support us.
Well, there you go. Steve Arpin's final words to the crowd.
Love it. He's running a QVC ad
in
right
commercial.
Now. Act now. Yeah, in show commercial. Hemp Fusion, act now. Arpin code, 25%, one time only.
Oh, you got to over 18 years old. Other offers may not apply.
Yeah, exactly. So we talked to Steve Arpin. We got Fraser McConnell up here. Fraser, Fraz, thank you.